Just counting how many there are of you on the couch, because there was a rival panel show complaining we had too many there. But a head count on the field at the Wacker on Saturday night, an extraordinary event.
Yeah,
does it reflect state of mind among the Eagles at the moment, or was it simple arithmetic than that?
No, at the time, Ozzie Jones was actually free in the West Coast Eagles defence. And they had a free, the West Coast Eagles actually had a free up the other end of the ground, and Guy McKenna obviously didn't see that they did. And I must admit, when the count started, I was a little bit concerned that maybe we did have one extra out in the field, because it can happen at different times where a player doesn't hear his name in the side, or thinks he's in the side, he was in the side, you know, in the first half or in the first quarter or whatever, and they go back out on the ground, and we've had to call players back at different times.
Did you have a moment of utter panic when you thought that?
You have a fairly colourful exchange on the phone sometimes, but in this instance, I mean, once we knew that we had our four interchange players, it was pretty clear.
But I don't mean to sound cynical about this, but this opens the door, I think, to a real problem on the eve of the finals. I mean, it could be the extension of the Malcolm Blight argument about sort of creating your own timeout, couldn't it?
Well, I suppose there's run-ons, but I mean, the one that gets me is that why wouldn't a coach, if his best player went off the ground, if Chris Grant or Wayne Carey, whoever, went off the ground through the blood rule, and you got a phone call saying that he was only going to take 3 minutes to re-stitch him up, call a count, and your 3 minutes is up and he's back on the ground.
Would you do that, Tim?
Yeah, look, I probably would, now that the loophole's actually been exposed. And I think that probably the AFL probably need to work pretty quickly to close it before the final series, because, look, I wouldn't have any hesitation at all in actually asking a player to ask the umpires for a count, because, you know, as Malcolm rightly said, one of the difficult things in modern football is actually to stop a run on and get that time where you can get the message to all the players about where perhaps you want them to change position to, and that type of thing. And I'd have no hesitation at all.